We've had a really nice evolution from two scrimmages, two exhibitions with two good opponents into this week. So we're very clear on the three things we're doing this week. That's including our midfield a little bit more, understanding what to do with chaos, and incorporating some different players. We have some really talented players coming off the bench, and really, where do you put them, how do you put them, and how do you adjust to them? That, along with learning about the importance of our attack penalty corners and what they mean to the outcome of a game. So I would say we're ready in terms of what we're doing tomorrow and Thursday, and if we can get through the things on our list, we'll be more than ready for Boston College on Friday.
Yeah, I'm really excited to get into our first real game. I think the two scrimmages we had really prepared us. We learned our weaknesses and our strong points, and we really focused on both to be able to exceed in this next game.
So when you have 10 seniors that have played together for 3 years, I'm looking for creativity. I think you're going to see it. I think you're going to see them maybe able to take the next level and not just go through the motions. There's a good infusion across the board of each class having a little something that you need in terms of finding the pieces of the puzzle. And for us, we don't want to finish the puzzle at the end of September like last year. We want to finish the puzzle starting Friday.
We're coming back from a lot of injuries in preseason, and I think we're really prepared to play in two games this weekend. We have to utilize every player, you know, their strengths and their weaknesses, and we have to know our opponents, be able to capitalize on their mistakes, and I think just working as a team, communication, and just elevating each other.
Like, she is just so good. I mean, when you see big players, a 6-foot-tall player who can move with that speed and agility and has that pace, you don't find that very often. And sometimes, quite frankly, that's all you recruit. You look for the size, the height, and the agility. Lauren, when we picked her up, had stick work and height and size, but has just evolved into such a wonderful defender. And I think she played behind Angie for a couple years, Angie King, and that taught her to have someone has her back. And I think she's learning right now that she's got to be that person for everybody else. She's a key player, but I think her diversity is that she knows how to make everyone else look good. There's never a moment where Lauren's trying to make Lauren look good. There's always a moment of what can I do that I can make the player up the line look good? How can I make a transfer ball look good?
I would say we just all work together. I'm working with Peyton primarily, Kira, and sometimes Livy, and I think we all work really well together. And it's not just one person this year that's going to be great, but I think all of us who are working off each other to be really successful.
Very humble. I would say her biggest weakness is working on her confidence and understanding how good she really is. You know, when you bring in a transfer who's a fifth year from another program, I think it's always difficult to figure out to find your place. So she spent a week and a half quietly finding her place, and then we had a meeting, and I said, okay, you're good now.
The transition actually has been going great. I expected things to be different. I expected there to be a lot of different challenges and new development of myself and others around me, but it's actually going really well. I love the team. Field hockey's a bit different. It's a different style of play, but it's going really well, and I'm loving it.
She has a wonderful voice, and she has a wonderful knowledge of the game. And I think once she's gotten over the fifth-year pains, it's hard to come and play preseason for the fifth year.
I cannot wait to get started. I've been, like, chomping at the bit just to get on the field and get to, like, a real game.
It's just a vital component in terms of thinking and looking at the game in a very different way than we do, and she's very open to discuss that. She's a great communicator.
I kind of have a different mindset. I came from a team that won two national championships. I've been to the Final Four times. It's bringing a level of elite mindset to the team and, like, exposing them to things that I've experienced that are a little bit different, but the girls are taking the challenges differently and well, and it's going great. I love being a leader on the team, and you hear me, I don't stop talking ever, so that helps when I'm allowed to just keep talking and, like, put my input in, and they're all taking and running with it, so it's great.
I think she is a piece of the puzzle in the midfield that's going to put us in another place. Really excited about what she's doing.
I hope to make it to the Big East tournament. I've been to four of them myself, and I hope we can make it there one more time to see my old team and just to be like, hey, look where we are. And that's one of my things, is like, let's push the limits this year. Let's get to where we haven't been before. This is a new conference. This is only their second year in it, and I hope that every single game we get better and better, and hopefully we make it to the Big East tournament, and from there we keep going.